This is my area. This is Kapogweni. I was born here. My parents were also born here. This is where I went to school. This is where I had my first boyfriend. And this is where I was told that I'm HIV positive. They didn't know the difference between HIV and AIDS. The sister will call you, you get in the room, and the sister told me that, no, Bongi, you got AIDS, and your child got AIDS, and you're gonna live just for five years. Your child will live for 3 years.
In the beginning, there was that problem that if you can come out and say that you are HIV positive, to them, it was like you are a curse to them. They hate you. They don't even speak to you.
In the same year, my son passed early in January. My father passed late in October. When I went to NAPWA, NAPWA, the National Association of People Living with HIV, those who are affected and infected, there were people there who were busy disclosing. It was like a support group when I get there. I see those people, they were nice, not tiny. You can see these people, wow, there are people who can live with this virus. While I was shocked and scared that I can live with HIV, I saw a lot of people, they were disclosing. Some, they told us that they were 5 years living with the HIV. Some, they were 10 years. There are people who are living for 20, 30 years. Why can't I do this myself? Like I said, no, I can't do it. I can do this. I can live longer. I told myself, no. I said, you know what? Let me go to Kapogweni Clinic and open my own support group where I can help others. I wanted to help them that AIDS is not a death sentence. You can live with it.
The first time I attended the conversations was after my friend invited me. So he's working for the foundation.
Community dialogue, a community capacity enhancement. It's where we get the community by mobilizing them, and it's where we want to hear them, the issues that they are having in HIV and AIDS. It's where we see where can the community change.
I learned more of how the disease, the pandemic affects people, you know, real life, and then just to gauge how I'll be affected if I'm infected, you know, so it was quite a daunting situation, really.
When you are at the dialogue, facilitating the dialogue, you can see the people, they are free to talk with you, they are free to show their views.
It helped people to come out, to talk to each other, to communicate what steps they must take in order to reduce this epidemic.
It's getting better and better, I must say. So I know people now who are HIV positive, but somehow I think over the years it's become bad. People deal with it better now because it's a bit more open, and then people know that they can get the treatment and live longer.
Since I became a facilitator, it made me change. That's why this is a community dialogue are so powerful, and being a facilitator, it has grown me inside from where I was.
And the most important thing is just to know that there are people out there who care for others with the disease.
We are all the same, and we all have the right as a human being.